when learning any art, and I do think game development is an art. It's a complex art that includes multiple mediums. When learning any art, I think in the beginning, at least for sure, quantity is almost more important than quality. I remember discovering singletons for the first time, and I remember feeling like I had just figured out the key to making classes talk to each other. I felt like I had really figured it out that, like, I get how you can make single responsibility things now. I was way wrong. And I still had not heard the term design patterns yet. Like, I heard the term singleton by itself, but I didn't realize that it was a, like, connected with a set of other implementations. I didn't even know what a design pattern was. I didn't know what a singleton was. And so I didn't really know that, what you use singletons for or what not to use them for or anything like that. And I didn't know that there were other design patterns out there that could help me. And so I was just super stoked that I figured out singletons. And so, of course, I made almost everything a singleton. And then I built my game like that, and it worked for a while. And I built an inventory system, and I built a crafting system. And because they were so tied together, the crafting system was literally embedded. The code was literally embedded in the code of the inventory, which is really bad. And then, my movement, everything about my character movement, I did figure out, I did learn about a state machine at around the same time. And so I had a massive, way overbloated state machine that handled my walking and sprinting and stamina and all my stats like hunger and thirst and breathing underwater. I had swimming, I had climbing, I had all these things, but they were all in one class. And so that class became thousands of lines long. The update method was hundreds of lines long. And when it came to trying to adjust anything or add a new functionality, it was extremely confusing. It got to the point where it got extremely confusing to adjust anything. This is now what I call monolith classes, meaning big, burly, immovable, unadjustable classes that if you try to move them, they're gonna snap and topple and break and ruin everything. So that was a lesson I learned from that. But I remember learning about singletons and having it be just a huge epiphany that I figured things out. And I think that those moments occur regularly in programming. And I think really in when learning probably any skill or any art, it's totally rejuvenating and it makes you have a sense of clarity. You finally feel like you get it and you understand how things work. And it's so fulfilling. And I think it's when you've messed with enough different things in all different types of like you've worked on lots of different projects that have all used, different types of systems and different things. And then I think the epiphany happens when it all connects in your head and you have all these systems that that you were working on this thing and then you kind of understood how that was working, but not quite. Maybe that used a, for me, like I had a event system and then, or I rather I had a basic event system that was like start game and, you know, quick game, whatever, and those were the events. And I thought that's like what delegates, that was like the extent of what you could do with a delegate is like, cool, you know, when the game starts, I can call a start game event, and then all the classes that use start game can use that. And I was using like messengers, like broadcasting messages and stuff. Really rough way to do it. But then that was a whole nother epiphany of like, oh, I get how those talk to each other. Now you can have a start game thing, and then all your and not just at start, I mean like when they press the start button, then it launches your game, shoots the event, and then everything goes off and starts your game. But I didn't really understand the full extent of delegates and what else you could use those for, and different and how powerful events and actions and unity events and things like that can be. I didn't understand that. So, but eventually I came across scriptable object-based events, and that was a massive epiphany. Suddenly I understood how delegates made sense, like on a larger scale. I understood scriptable objects on a larger scale when I had already been using them, but I didn't really understand them very well. I, you know, was putting everything under the same scriptable objects folder because I didn't understand really what they're for. And so they're, first of all, they're like an alternative to mono behavior. They're an extension of a class. They're like a structure for your class. So, or a set of behaviors for your class. So to put all scriptable objects under the same category is silly. They're not, you're not putting all your classes under the same category. But anyway, so it was the epiphany of all those things lining up that that finally just I had a sense of clarity. I see how this and this and this line up, and it was many pathways coming together that gave me that epiphany. But that wouldn't have happened had I not spent a lot of time exploring and trying different games, because I used these things in different games, and I like carried code over and retried things and whatever, and all the bad practice. And had I not done that, had I not experimented with all those different games, it wouldn't have been, I wouldn't have gotten to the point that I'm at. I wouldn't have learned all the wrong ways to do it. I wouldn't have learned all the wrong ways to use these things, and I probably did take a longer path than was necessary. It probably was not the fastest way to learn, but it was a very thorough way to learn. That I saw firsthand why not to do these things, firsthand why people warn against these things. So, I think there were great lessons actually, and I think I now have a deeper understanding of the right way to do things because I did the wrong things for so long. I guess my conclusion to this is that I think experimenting is important, and I think that I think that when learning any art, and I do think game development is an art, it's a complex art that includes multiple mediums. When learning any art, I think in the beginning, at least for sure, quantity is almost more important than quality. You want to try lots of different things and get your get. You want to face all kinds of different problems that if you stick with one project, you're only going to see so many problems. And those problems are going to be layered, and you're going to get to deeper levels of it, and you're going to have deeper understandings of those problems, and that's good. But that stuff you should learn in the long term, as to where I feel like I would have learned faster had I not stuck with one project for so long as I did. And I feel like I would have learned faster had I experimented a lot more, right away. And so I think just trying lots of different games, and I think that's why it's encouraged to make lots of small games and prototypes and things, because you learn so much. You learn so much from each one. You carry over some techniques that you learned in the previous one. You think you're doing it the right way, and you have all these everything figured out, and then you start to hit walls that you weren't facing in your previous project because you were doing it a certain way. But now you have to adapt this to something new, or your skill set to something new, and it becomes a whole new set of challenges that you have to then like learn a new way of doing the same thing you just did. And like that makes you far more formidable, the skill far more robust. So I encourage people to experiment a lot and make lots of different things when you're first starting out, and really continuously. Like that's why rapid prototyping is so valuable. Because you should be able to quickly experiment with things, see what works, what doesn't, and not only will that make your game better, but that will make you better as a developer. I am curious what kinds of problems people have faced like this, or what kind of like epiphany moments have other people had. Like for me, singletons was one of them, delegates was one of them, scriptable objects was one of them, and then learning how to do scriptable object-based events was a huge one, and like that was a bunch of pathways coming together at once. So I'm curious if other people have had this type of these type of moments, or I'm sure everybody has, but I'm curious what were the big breakthrough moments that you had that led to a deeper understanding of the medium. I want to take a second to thank everybody. I posted one video last week that was 3 minutes long, and I got 62 subscribers off of my first video. So it was really motivating. It really makes me want to keep doing this. So thank you to everybody, and I hope to keep making good stuff. So I'll see you next time.